Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Sahabat Lorong Edukasi, in this opportunity, I will explain about the nature of life. The nature of life. The first characteristic of the nature of life is light can travel in a straight line. Light travel in a straight line primarily due to the fact that light is a wave. However, light can change its path away from a straight line when it is incident on certain obstacles. This effect is commonly referred to as diffraction. Since diffraction is very small effect, light is generally assumed to travel in straight line. In this image, you can now, there is a candlelight, can through the light on the straight line. The second part of the nature of light is light can penetrate clear objects. Materials like air, water, and clear glass are called transparent. When light encounters transparent materials, almost all of it passes directly through them. Glass, for example, is transparent to all visible light. Translucent objects allow some light to travel through them. The third characteristic of the nature of light is reflection. Reflection of light and other form of electromagnetic radiation occurs when the waves encounter surface or other boundary that does not absorb the energy of the radiation and bounce the waves away from the surface. There is three types of mirror. The first mirror, this is a plane mirror or flat mirror, and the second, this is a concave mirror, and the last, this is a convex mirror. The next, about the nature of light, about the refraction of light. Refraction is the bending of light. It also happens with sound, water, and other waves as it passes from one transparent substance into another. This bending by refraction makes it possible for us to have lens, magnifying glasses, prisms, and rainbows. In the left figure, we can see there is a pencil put on the water on the glass. And the pencil occurring the refraction of light. Dispersion. Dispersion of light is the phenomenon of splitting of visible light into its component colors. It's called dispersion. Dispersion of light is caused by the change of speed of light ray, resulting in angle of deviation of its wavelength by a different amount. We know there is a white light through to the glass prisms will be make a dispersion, create some colors. The first red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. All of the visible light, it is, has a different wavelength, different frequency, and of course, have the different energy. Next, about interferation. Interferation of light is the phenomena of multiple light waves interfering with one another under certain circumstances, causing the combined amplitude of the waves to either increase or decrease. On the right, this is a figure about the interference phenomena. There is constructive interference and destructive interference. Constructive interference occurs along line like this one and create the like pattern. And destructive interference occurs along line like this one and create the dark line or the dark pattern. Next, about the nature of light is diffraction. Diffraction of light. Diffraction is the slight bending of light as it passes around the edge of an object. The amount of bending depends on the relative size. Okay, the amount of bending depends on the relative size of the wavelength of light to the size of the opening. Optical effects resulting from diffraction are produced through the interference of light waves. On the right, this is the figure about the diffraction phenomena. We can see there is incoming wave to the slit. Okay, slit, this is a celah, yeah, slit. And there is a distance between slit and the screen or viewing screen, we know L. So the pattern consists of a central break, this is a central break, fringe flange by much weaker maxima alternating with dark fringes. Sorry, with dark fringe. And last about the polarization of light. An ordinary beam of light consists of a large number of waves emitted by the atoms of the light source. Each atom produces a wave having some particular orientation of the electric field vector E, corresponding to the direction of atomic vibration. The direction of polarization of its individual wave is defined to be the direction in which the electric field is vibrating. We can see together, there is a light beam, okay, light beam, and before through the polarizer, it will become an unpolarized light. But after through the polarizer, this light beam become a polarized light. Okay, we can see in this live figure. Figure A show that a representation of an unpolarized light beam feed along the direction of propagation. The transfer electric field can vibrate in any direction in the plane of the phase with equal probability. And B, it is so that a light early polarized light beam with the electric field vibrating in the vertical direction. It's a figure explained about what the phenomena about in polarization or unpolarization like.
Now we can prove about the angle of incident light is equal to with the angle of reflected light. I am using a laser. This is in 40 degrees. Okay, 40 degrees. And you can see the reflected light. Same to in 40 degrees, 10, 20, 13, and 40. Okay, last, this is the plane mirror. The plane mirror usually we use in our daily activity, especially for makeup. If the object is located in front of the mirror, so the characteristic of the image we can see, the first is virtual image upright and has the same size. It means that the distance of the image to the mirror is the same with the distance of the object to the mirror. We use the concave mirror. This is a concave mirror. When the object is located in front of the concave mirror, we can see that the characteristic of the image is virtual image, upright and enlarged. It means that the size of the image is more than the size of the object. Thank you. Okay, now we can use the concave mirror to make the form of the image of the object. When the object is located between focal length and the radius in front of the concave mirror, so the image characteristic is real, inverted, and enlarged. The size of the image is more than the size of the object. Let's now weaken the convex mirror. If the object is located in front of the convex mirror, so the characteristic of the image is virtual, upright, and reduced size. It means that the size of the image is less than the size of the object.